the land of the Apalachee, forefathers of the Seminoles and Creeks, marked by giant magnolias and oaks, land of natural wealth and the home of granddaddy thunderstorms. And we've had a succession of them today, as today the top-ranked Florida State Seminoles will attempt to turn away the invaders from the north, Syracuse Orangemen. The weather, the temperature is 80 degrees. The cup runneth over in humidity. The wind is nominal and the rain has been very heavy. Now one of the most extravagant beginnings anywhere in college football. Chief Osceola, Riding Renegade. The Chief is a Florida State University student. The costume, authentic Seminole. The horse is a real Appaloosa. Gudry Ismail, he is the bigger and younger brother of Raghib Ismail, who was the rocket at Notre Dame. They call this one the missile. Perry Richardson back there with him. Dan Mowry, who had a miserable weekend up in Michigan, kicks it off. It goes to Ismail at the six-yard line. And Gudry comes up across the 15 to started as a freshman, billed as an option offense, but you can see he really is not a running threat out of this offense. But there are plenty of people behind him that can haul the mail, in particular David Walker, and you will see Terry Richardson as the game wears on. The wideouts are very, very quick, and the tight end is a very good receiver, Chris Gedney. They start out of the I formation. There's your freeze option. They pitch it back to the tailback, David Walker. And David Walker breaks a couple of tackles and gets loose on the sidelines and is finally thrown out of bounds. The Orangemen have took him at the Florida State 44. They're playing on prescription turf. It is held up very well. Pitch it back open. To Graves. Down the middle. Goes for Ismail. He's open. He's got it. Touchdown, Syracuse! There are no flags. The ball was given to the running back. He pitched it back to the quarterback. A semi-flea flicker play. He's missed just, he needs two to break the all-time Syracuse record, and now he needs one. And the big crowd is stunned in Tallahassee. 7-0 Syracuse. As the Orangemen kick off, Pat O'Neill, who has knocked it into the end zone 23 out of 25 times. He's beat up and banged up. He had a tough day last week up in Ann Arbor, Michigan, even though his team did score 51 points to win. He's very sore, and in particular, the right leg. The rest of the backs are Edgar Bennett, outstanding receiver at fullback, great blocker. Ant Lee is the electrifying tailback, and the wideouts can all fly. Walker and Ismail are making the two big plays. First down for the Florida State Seminoles. And they hand it off to Lee, and Lee finds daylight on the line and crosses the 35 and goes to the 40. The offensive front for Florida State, not all that big, but they get the job done. But Lee turned in one of the best 44-yard runs I've ever seen last week against Michigan, and that was a good one right there. And here he goes again. A little juke here and a little juke there. The ball comes out. It is down. Well, it's second down. Long three. Syracuse jumping out to a 7-0 lead. Rowland gives the ball away to Lee. He's got a first down as the ball moves across the way. Brooks is their principal man in the middle. Kevin Mitchell will go nose guard as well as outside linebacker. They lost Dan Conley. He was an outstanding linebacker, and they miss him. Their backers are Wooden and Hawkins outside with Young and Lusardi inside, and the secondary reflected there. First down for the Seminoles at the Syracuse 48. Weldon hands the ball away, and it is Bennett, and Bennett can't find much room on each side. So they miss and Auburn. Weldon gives the ball away again. Casey Weldon again with... And the water is still being sucked out of the ground. Weldon sets it up, gets it away in a hurry, and Shannon Baker dropped the ball.
And missed.
Scott Player is in to punt for Florida State. And that's news as the Seminole just short of the 14-yard line. The tailback is Terry Richardson. Marvin Graves, the quarterback, keeps the ball and turns it upfield. This again is not one of those huge things that we saw early on in the season. There are no 300-pounders there at Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Second down, about two, Porter Richardson. He sticks his helmet in the crowd. He's very close. 24-yard line for the Orangemen. They lead 7-0. I keep saying that in case you're joining us a little late, because Florida State isn't behind very often. There's your freeze option. They come off of it. The pass is thrown across the field up to about the 35-yard line. Florida State defensive unit lines up with three down, but you'll see those outside backers come up the line more often than not. So effectively, they'll be playing sometimes at eight-man front because they will come after you. The inside backers are the leading tacklers. The secondary is quite good, and Terrell Buckley, of course, was quite a star last Saturday. First down for the Orange. Brothers bouncing around. Now he's coming, comes to the outside. The pass is thrown to the outside. And crowd trying to get into it. And Marvin Graves went for a checkoff. Phillips consulted with one of his colleagues. And it's second down and about 15 from the 30. It is a first down for the Orange, just over the 40, call it the 41. Graves is 4 out of 5 now for 71 yards and the touchdown. Here's your option, goes to Richardson, a little skip step trying to cut back inside.
But the terminology on offense and defense is the same.
Second down and 6 for Syracuse. Graves gives it to his fullback, Al Wooten, and Wooten... Walker is the deep man. Richardson goes up into a slot now. Crowd coming up, making as much noise as they can. Graves has time, lets it go. It's Ismail. He's out there. It's off his hands, incomplete. Pat O'Neill, one of the big legs in college football right now, and he hits it toward the corner, but I think he bought the sideline well back upfield. They mark it. Day 40-3 over Oklahoma State. From the 16-yard line, there's Ant Lee again. When you think you've got him down on... And the Orangemen are leading the Seminoles 7-0 as Weldon goes back. Wanted to throw it down the middle. Play was taken away from him. Number 77 reaches across and gets a piece of him. That's Big Jim Wentworth. Third down. 5. This is Edgar Bennett. Bennett has a first down. From the 32. Weldon goes underneath. Pass is caught by Matt Fryer. They were the ground game. Anthony, a little move right, a little move left, and then bingo, gone.
Has gone to the Rose Bowl 4 of the last 6 years.
On first down, Casey Weldon comes back, looks for the big one. It's not there. He goes underneath, with it, set up the screen for Edgar Bennett. Bennett will pick up a couple of yards on. Weldon to throw it, has time, and goes underneath with it to pass 2 knocks. And the sophomore, a 44-yard play with Quadri Ismail, making the catch and run for the touchdown from Marvin Graves. This handoff goes inside to the fullback, Bennett. Second effort by Bennett.
Everybody thought would be there. Kansas City has struggled just a little.
Ant Lee with the ball, skips and slides, and then gets decked. And he... Second down. Here goes Knox. I mean, they take out one, they put in another one. Lee spins away from a tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Call it second down and 10 from the Syracuse 13. Weldon rolls out. Pass into the end zone. Touchdown! Fire! Dan Mowry, who had the miserable weekend at Michigan, nails it. He's pretty good at home.
He's pretty excited right now.
Casey Weldon has hit his last 5. You want to see something that's truly, genuinely fun? Let's go back a week.
He came down in buckets.
Big buckets. Mowry, good kick. Ismail, 6-yard line. Quadri finds a hole. Still going. Great speed. He's gone. He's got one man with an angle. He won't catch him. It is touchdown, 94 yards. Ismail, no flags. Is something in the genes of the Ismail boys. I'll just get for the extra point try. It is good. Well, he is now the all-time Syracuse return man.
Was that the kicker?
Yep.
Looks like he turned his back, and I don't think that's a clip. If you turn your back when you're going to be blocked, I think it's a good no call by the official.
Tiger McMillan handling O'Neill's kickoff, and it can impact the will of a team. Amp Lee to the 30-yard line. It's against Florida State. The holding. This is Amp Lee. He is quite remarkable. He wiggles in the top rank team in the nation, trailing as we come down to the end of the first quarter. There's the attempt at the screen pass. And so number one trails number 10 after a quarter of play, 14-7.
76.
Casey Weldon all day lets it go, and it's a fraction too high. And it's scrimmage. Shelby Hill is deep. Scott Player punts it out of there, gets it nice and high. Shelby Hill with very sore ribs makes the catch, can't get away. Goes down in the puddle of water at the 28-yard line.
That's for sure.
He keeps it himself much of the time. Ismail comes into the backfield, and they set up now on a wishbone. Here he goes down the line on the option. He pitches it out to Ismail. And Quadri turns it upfield and picks up about 9 yards.
Be a good positive play.
Second down and one. Same set. Except they're wide to the open side of the field. They give it inside to the fullback, Marcus Lee. For a respite. And Graves sets him up on first down at the 39-yard line. Hand keeps it himself, and he is sacked. Marvin Jones, sophomore, inside the linebacker. You're not supposed to blitz.
And brought a backup nose tackle over. He's starting at left guard.
And they're playing well. It's third down and 12. And Graves back. Pass is away. The pass is incomplete. It was intended for Antonio Johnson. Tight spin on it. You'll knock it up in the clouds. Like that. Terrell Buckley, 24-yard line. Not quite. He found a little bit of a crack.
12 of the last 15, too, Keith.
First down. Here they go as Casey Weldon sets up the Seminoles offense. Goes underneath to Lonnie Johnson, the tight end.
And especially, they're a physical team up front, but zones behind.
Weldon again opens it up. Got a man. Goodness, the ball was tipped a little bit.
Hayden giving you the business for not giving Iowa enough credit.
I like Iowa.
Weldon to give Amp Lee. And Amp Lee just sort of sliding, skating along. And next Saturday here on ABC Sports. Weldon's pass to the sideline. Good to Knox.
He may not be as fast as the other ones, and you need good foot runners on this field today.
First down. Nothing there. Eric Terrell, number 7, is back at wideout for the Seminoles. Little screenplay that one may love to run for.
But you've got to believe that Graves is having the more productive day so far.
Third down and 10. Weldon goes down the middle. Has it. Complete to Edgar Bennett. It's inside the 20. First down, Seminoles at the Syracuse 18. Big Warren Hart is in there now, the 260-pound tight end. Pitch it to Amp Lee. And Lee stretches for a couple of yards. Underneath it goes, and it is thrown just a little bit behind Lee. Third down and eight. This is Bennett. Up the middle he goes. First down. Sheldon kept it. Lobs it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bennett.
Dangerous throw, but when you have confidence in your receiver, you can do that.
Mowry hits his second successive point after, and we're even again at 14. Took a beating last week. He's getting whacked around again today, but he is a tough guy. Ismail. Oh, my goodness. He had a crack. And Graves, the quarterback. Richardson, the tailback. Richardson has the pick. Brought down. Clifton Abraham. Graves. Buried. Penalty flag thrown by the referee. Let's see about the penalty. Holding Syracuse. And it's certainly third and long right now. Third and 27. Long deep pass downfield is incomplete. Intended for Farrell. Low spinner. 45-yard line. Buckley with a little daylight. Down at the 40. Oh. How loud is it? Pass across the field. Shannon Baker. Baker for the Seminoles today also. Ball is at the 28-yard line. Chance for Casey Welder to catch another one as he fires a bullet to Baker down at the 10. Syracuse defense can't afford to be on the field too long because it's a hot, humid day, even though it has been raining. And that pass is tipped, and it is incomplete. Second down. Give it to Lee. Amp Lee is caught by Glenn Young.
Arizona never got inside the 28-yard line in the Aloha Bowl.
Yeah, it was 28 zip or something like that.
Third down from the 10-yard line. Pass to the end zone by Weller. He tried to throw it hard. He had his man. The rehabilitation of Dan Mowry continues now as he comes out for a field goal try from 27 yards approximately. Looks more like 28. 28. It's up. It's good. He may not need a psychologist this coming week. 17-14, Seminoles lead.
A few years ago, they were deciding whether to take Mowry or J.D. Carlson, the kicker at Michigan, and they decided on Mowry.
That kick's a good one down to the 6-yard line where Terry Richardson, the tailback, finds some running room. Out to the 35. Three down linemen for Florida State. Look at that line. There's five people lined up 5 yards back of them. A ricochet catch by the tight end, Chris Gedney. His second catch of the day. First down. The gain is up to the 46. Now the Orange men with a lot of real estate behind them. Graves down the line. Keeps it. Turns it. Gets a yard, and that's all.
Does not like the run and does not run the option very well when he runs it himself.
Second down, 9.5.
Reverse.
Here comes Ismail. Shows the man in front of him where he wants it blocked. It's against Florida State. Graves. Gives it to his tailback, Walker. Second down, 9. A little wiggle, pitch back. That was not successful. Too slow to develop. Dan Footman's almost lined up in the neutral zone, but gets away with it. Marvin Graves throws, and it is intercepted by Terrell Buckley. How did he do that?
Came over the top. Goes over and makes the play.
This is an All-American play.
This is outstanding. Ooh. This is his fourth interception of the year. His 13th of his career. And that's a big time play. He had two pickoffs last week against Michigan.
Casey Weldon trying to get it away. Syracuse batting it around. And they don't get the interception when, in fact, it looked like they were going to.
Bennett saved an interception there when he knocked it away.
Yes, he did. They set up a screen. It goes to Knox. And Kevin Knox is out for a first down. Both teams have three timeouts remaining. Weldon throwing. Got a man, Knox, up at midfield. It's another first down. No huddle. Good protection. They flush him. Penalty flag. And Weldon runs out of bounds. Cool. Referee is
coming down with this weather outside the carrier dome. You know, inside, it's all, everything's perfect.
This is Ant Lee.
He won't be eligible for this playoffs.
Well, that's right. Yeah. That'll do it. We get a little ruckus going on the field, but they step in and stop that nonsense. And the half is over, 17-14, Florida State. Back with halftime after this message and the word from our ABC station. Ready for the second half to get underway. The deep people are Felix Harris and Tiger McMillan for Florida State. O'Neill kicks it off. It'll go to the end zone, and it will not be returned by Felix Harris. First half possessions for Florida State. Took them a while to get started, but once they did right well. So let's see what happens. This could be quite a big moment right here in this ball game as Ant Lee, who's...
Florida State comes out of the locker room ready for a bear in the third quarter.
Bennett for the first down out to the 32-yard line. But we'll see. They've had a pretty good record on grass outdoors. Weldon's pass to the sidelines. Normally a dangerous pass.
Makes it simple. Just one-on-one out there.
Second down and two, and it's Ant Lee going outside for the first down. And he gets it up to about the 49. They lead 17-14, just starting the second half of play. Number one against number 10. All day for Weldon, and he lets her rip for Baker. Caught it! 1 yard line. A rainbow. Bennett, touchdown. For the extra point out of Brad Johnson. Hold is missed it. Uh-oh. And we're at second down and 9.
Who would have ever thought that Atlanta would come back and win after the last few years, huh? The Braves?
I'll tell you about it in a minute. Second down and 9. Braves with that little freeze option going down the line. Hooks his pass downfield, and it is incomplete. Atlanta was a 100-1 choice. Third down and 9. They got Braves. 97 is the man. Gets it out and gets it well out. He runs Buckley all the way back to the 24-yard line. He's got some help, but not enough. And goes down. Kind of strange sometimes. On first down from the 27-yard line. Back him up 5 on first down. Slip by Lee, and down he goes. Second down, call it 16. Casey Weldon lets it go, has a man. Eric Terrell. And it's first down. First down, 48-yard line. Pitch it back to Lee. Let him search a little bit, and he trips. He and his wife, Lori, both graduate this coming December. Weldon's pass to the sidelines again. He got that one-on-one matchup over there, and it was for Terrell against Walker. It is third down and 2. And he doesn't get it. I'll be surprised if anybody gets it other than Ant Lee, and I'm already surprised. because they throw the ball to Eric Terrell, and Greg Walker put a heck of a play on it. It's a big opportunity now for the Orangemen from the 43. Marvin Graves all day to throw it down the middle. The ball is slapped down. Claims there'll be no party at Toomer's Corner tonight. Doug Womack, your quarterback. The option doesn't work. It is third down and nine. Marvin needs to make something happen right here for the Orangemen. Let's it go deep. Too long. Penalty flag.
Buckley's going to hit him. Now he hits him again. And the ball is in the air. You'll see the flag.
15-yard penalty, first down. 41-yard line of Florida State. For Syracuse. Touchdown to give them some new life. Inside handoff goes to the fullback, Al Wooten. Big pileup this time. Second down and nine. Little pop pass to the sidelines, incomplete, intended for Qadri Ismail. Third down and nine. Marvin Graves back, pressure coming. Screen pass set up for Greg Walker, David Walker. And David is caught by Buckley and thrown down. Holding call against Syracuse.
Yeah.
Third down now and 27. After getting the time back on the clock. Graves gets it away. It's up in the air and incomplete. Here. Buckley is back. And it bounces into the end zone. Old Florida. Casey Weldon pumps, lets it fly for Shannon Baker, and he can't get to it.
70 yards.
This is Antley, Anthony, and to the 24. Now for the Seminoles, it is third down and six. Knox breaks it off, he's wide open, pass goes instead to Edgar Bennett. Bennett rolls on up the field and is down around the 45-yard line. Ball came out.
Well, now it does.
Second down, 11. Bennett to the 49. Here's Roger. Amp Lee is back in. Casey Weldon is back. Let it rip. Baker. Baker has caught five balls now today for 138 yards.
Because you take a look at Ismail. Last week, Desmond Hire was back there. They didn't kick to him, and they're not kicking to Ismail in the second half. Second time they've popped it up.
Yeah, Jeepers, you got to kick it a little better than that. Has some time and throws an interception. Throws it right to Clifton Abraham. Florida State threatening to blow this baby wide open. Snap. And goes to Big Jackson. Sean will pick up about 3 yards.
Cheer. Those three touchdowns today give him 13 on the year.
Weldon loops it outside. Pass is caught by Warren Hart. And he's the load. Ball is on the 44. First down. This is Sean Jackson again. Weldon's yardage, 328 today. That is a career high. Second down and five. Here goes Jackson again. less seasoning him. UCLA back to the lead over California. That's been a seesaw. Big game in the Pac-10. Weldon. Fryer. Can't hold it.
At half, and now at the end of the third quarter, they're leading 30-14.
Jackson. Well, it's against Florida State.
Yeah, personal foul, and he is out.
And it was Baker, apparently, the center. Huh?
To give you an idea of how things have been going for Syracuse as you watch the safety develop here with McIntosh sacking the quarterback in the end zone. In the first quarter, Syracuse went for 121 yards. Since that time, they've had 23. Pat O'Neill from the 20. Ooh. He's got a leg and a half. All the way back just inside the 10-yard line for Terrell Buckley.
These.
Uh-huh. One here, one there. Weldon over to Jackson. Sean Jackson. And there are enough white shirts over there to bring him down on the
quarterbacks that they have.
Charlie Ward in particular. This is Sean Jackson. That gets him a first down at their own 47-yard line. Casey Weldon is hit.
Was it Homer Smith, the offensive coordinator out there?
Yep. Screen pass. Got it to Edgar Bennett. Bennett's got a first down. The Syracuse, when he was a mere lad romping around the piney woods here, they called him Buddy. This is Sean Jackson to the 12. Here comes Jackson. Touchdown. Eight carries for Jackson, 68 yards and a touchdown. The point is good. 39-14. Number one leads number 10. Seminoles kick it off. Maury hits it high. Didn't want to kick it to Kadra Ismail, and it's accepted at the 26-yard line where Syracuse will go to work. And first down. Boy, they'll be partying around Fulton County tonight, won't they? Not to mention DeKalb, Cobb, and all the others.
Uh-huh.
And here comes David Walker.
Well, nobody slowed him down yet. I don't know if anybody can.
I don't either.
There's your option pitch to Walker. First down as David spins it up across the 40 to the 42. 39-14 ball game. Florida State in control. Graves back. Dumps it off. Is that lateral? No, they're waving it off as an incomplete. That's David Walker, not much.
Don McPherson, Dick McPherson really set up the program, turned it around, and it's a tribute to both of those men that they've won their first four ball games this year.
Graves lets it go down the middle. He's got a man right there, Antonio Johnson. First down, 37. Pitch it out, got away with it. They held the ball a long time behind the line of scrimmage. Inside play to Marcus Lee.
But they were a little beat up coming out of the Michigan game. He didn't know how they were going to react in this game. But it seems like they've done very well.
Well, that's how you take care of the freeze option right there.
So Southern Cal's not playing their song as much as the Seminoles are.
Not now, no. That ball is thrown a little bit behind. Whoa, he threw that thing hard.
Brad Johnson is now the quarterback. He's a former starter, so he's not green. And this is Tiger McMillan.
Boy, you do that awfully well, Jack.
Carrying the ball is Omar Ellison on a reverse.
Fifth-year senior.
He's really big and strong. Just flicks that ball out there. Pass is caught by Eric Terrell. Nothing doing for Tiger McMillan that time. Just William Floyd in the I formation now for Florida State. Johnson lets it go. And it is incomplete. Eric Terrell, Michigan, Iowa. Wolverines would seemingly have it in hand. Here comes your didn't give it. Jackson kept it. Sean Jackson rumbling on down the road. Out of bounds at the 23. Expect they would. And he's been turned upside down a few times here today. Look at that. Tiger McMillan. Kevin Mitchell brings him down inside the 15.
And Bowden just continues to bring him in here.
Marquette Smith has had a bruise on his arm and the bicep. He simply can't hold the ball. That pass
about Washington, but we've seen him twice this year and a bunch of times last year.
The only team I know of that... Oh, Jackson wide open. No, Lonnie Johnson. Lonnie Johnson wide open. And Johnson, Brad Johnson just laid it right on his number.
Well coached.
Kick is good. Maury's had a pretty good day. He's only missed one. 3:12 to go in the ball game. It's now 46-14 as Johnson and Johnson hook up.
Johnson and Johnson.
I mean, Joe won't give it to Usman. And the return. Mark McDonald, a fifth-year senior now out of Klein, Texas. He's in at quarterback. Mark McDonald. Herbie Dardar is in the lineup. Dardar is number 42. So here's the first play for Mark McDonald. Hands it off. Dardar carries. That Oklahoma was the last team, 1985, to start and finish a season first in the AP poll. So Florida State was the preseason number one. Mark McDonald gets mugged behind the line of scrimmage by Sterling Palmer. Good punt. Nobody back. And it's kicked out of bounds and it goes out.
But he said, I ran your play, Steve, but I couldn't call it Gator. I had to call it Crocodile. I just couldn't bring myself to call it a Gator.
Remember those names? This is Jason Pierce carrying the ball. Everybody getting to play now for the Seminoles. Inside, Pierce again carrying the ball. And so number one has defeated number 10, but number 10 put some scare in them. It was close at halftime. Florida State 46, Syracuse 14.